Teamwork.
Was that yourself that just put that in?
Yeah.
That's a calm and composed finish, that.
I'm focusing too much on the game rather than the questions. I'm not getting to know anyone here.
The Premier League finals are nearly here, and today we are at Fulham to talk everything FC24 and football. But we are joined by Fulham left-back Antonee Robinson, Chris and Josh, who both will be representing Fulham at the Premier League finals. To start things off, we're going to go through and talk about your ultimate dream team for FC24 with Fulham. In goal, we're going to have the options of Thunderstruck icon Edwin van der Sar or Petr Cech Team of the Year icon. Antonee, you have any sort of preference for which goalkeeper you might want?
I mean, looking at them, Cech's got better stats than everything, so yeah. Cech, no?
I'd say Cech as well, personally.
Would you? Josh?
I prefer van der Sar when we play the finals, but I do agree with the point of Cech. He's obviously a good keeper as well, both very tall as well. There's no height difference here. I'm happy with Cech.
Well, there we are then. Cech is going to be locked in that goalkeeper position. Nice and simple for the first one. Moving over to our right back, we have Trent Alexander-Arnold's Team of the Year honorable mentions item or Rico Lewis Future Stars. Josh, have you used either one of these items in FC24?
I haven't, but the way sort of FC24 is at the moment, Trent probably has sort of the better stats. Overall, obviously that long pass, obviously incredible, but also the height difference as well between Trent and Rico Lewis will play a big factor, but could be different based off if you prefer pace of Rico Lewis or not.
Antonee, a fullback yourself. You take a look at either of them two items and think it's a difficult one?
Just looking at it, I'd always look at pace, so I'd probably go Lewis, but like you said, I'm not thinking as in-depth as in-depth he is.
And the modern-day fullback has kind of evolved a lot. We see so many different type of fullbacks that are more comfortable on the ball. For yourself, getting up and down that pitch, you think that's something that's kind of elevated your game?
Yeah, but like you said, like I used to think of myself as a modern fullback, but now a modern fullback plays a bit more like a centre-mid, so I feel more like a dying breed now, to be honest.
But I'm sure Fulham fans may disagree. Chris, you have a preference on either item?
Probably Trent like him as well. The same reason, whip pass.
We'll have that then, and at right back, Trent Alexander-Arnold. You let us know down below in the comments who would you choose. Over to centre back, and we have some tough options here. The Vincent Kompany fantasy hero or the Rio Ferdinand Team of the Year item. Chris, what are you thinking when you look at either one of those two items?
I think that Rio car is very good, but the Kompany can still get upgraded if I'm not mistaken, but I'd say Rio all day.
Josh?
Cards actually do look identical, but Ferdinand feels a little bit better for me when I've been practicing at home.
I'll go Ferdinand as well, yeah.
Making it nice and simple for us. Ferdinand will take that centre-back option. And then on the left-hand side for centre-back, we have Issa Diop or Tosin Adarabayo as our options. Obviously, two teammates for yourself. Is there a preference?
I mean, they've done Issa dirty with his pace there, to be honest. There's no chance he's that much slower than Toss. I think they're about the same pace, to be honest. Yeah, based purely on game card, I'm going with Toss.
I think we'll have to agree. Ante's probably got the best knowledge, so we'll go with that.
Now at left-back, we're not actually really going to give you much of a choice here because we're going to have yourself. The Team of the Week item that you picked up, and we were saying about how this was used in-game by plenty of FC24 players. Are you happy with that item?
Looks all right, yeah. Take it, yeah.
Chris, you said that you actually used Robinson
in
qualifiers.
Yeah, very good card.
You're going to make me blush, mate.
Yeah, that's all right.
It must be a bit surreal for yourself, though, to see yourself kind of in the game as well.
Like, I literally remember the first time I was in seeing a bronze card back in my Everton Academy days, and I was buzzing with that.
Yeah.
And now, you know, it's a little bit more normalised, but still, you know, getting your face scanned in and your boys playing with you, it's could be cool.
Well, let's head on over to the midfield positions, and we do have the option of Steven Gerrard's Future Stars item or the fantasy foot Declan Rice.
Depends if you use them as more of a CDM or an 8. Obviously, Gerrard's shooting and passing's better, but Deckers is better defensively. Attacking-wise, I'd probably have to pick Gerrard.
And Josh?
I agree. It depends on who's obviously the next centre-mid, but we like to try and play a bit more attacking football around here, so I agree with Antonee and say Gerrard.
I'll disagree and say Rice.
Okay, why is that?
Height and more physical than Gerrard, really.
Well, it is 2-1, so it will be Gerrard, but we'll just take that centre mid role. Partner him, though, in midfield. We have the option of João Paulinho Team of the Week item, and then also the Radiactive Casado item. Are you going to go for your teammate here?
I mean, purely just off the fact that we've just picked Gerrard to be really attacking, I'd pick João for the defence. His defensive stats look a little bit better than Caicedo's there.
And what's it like having someone like João playing with you in the real-life game, knowing that if you do get forward, he's such a good physical presence in that midfield?
That's amazing. You know, he's a specialist at what he does off the ball. I think easily the best I've played with off the ball. On the ball, he's a pretty good player as well, but off the ball, he's just a monster. And knowing you've got someone like that adds that physical presence to the team and, you know, it can be intimidating to opponents. And, you know, it's like a little bit of a lifeline as well when a team's breaking against you.
And we see so many people in FC24 at the minute using, you know, big strikers, and Paulinho could be a type of player that will be able to combat with that.
No, I totally agree. Like I said, sort of at the moment in FC24, a lot of it is trying to get that cross up to someone with that aerial plus play style, or someone with obviously a lot of height, and Paulinho definitely will be able to help with that a lot for sure.
Chris?
All three, I guess. We're going to have to agree on that one, so.
Well, let's head on over to that right mid position. And we do have the options of Adama Traore or Leon Bailey. You're going to go for your teammate again.
I mean, he'll probably batter me if I don't. Physically wise, I feel like if he's running, probably be a lot harder to deal with than Bailey. But Bailey's cards stats look a little bit better if you're, you know, cutting in with a left foot and shooting. Probably go for Adama.
Well, you're saying it quite right, because on FC24, that kind of is what a lot of people look for right now, to get past their fullback, beat the man, and then get that cross in. Would Adama be the one that you go for, Chris?
Adama Traore is a train, isn't he? So probably get in front of the fullback. They can't get back in front of him. So. Especially he's got an upgraded card as well.
Yeah, that upgraded card's really good. So I used him at right back for a long time, and especially as a sub compared to him who've got tired legs on the game, with his strength and pace, no one could beat him.
And over to that next position now, we are going to have that option of future stars Cole Palmer or the future stars Wayne Rooney.
Both look really similar cards, to be honest. Probably have to go Palmer, I think. Purely just stats seem really identical. I heard these talking about height before. Palmer might be a bit taller. That's the only thing I can think of.
And Palmer does have those two playstyle pluses, which they make a massive impact in the game, don't they, Josh?
Especially having quick step and finesse shot plus.
Well, 100%. And like I said, Palmer's obviously finesse. Obviously, it's come over the last sort of only few weeks in the game. The finesse has come a lot more stronger. And Rooney obviously does have Travella, but sadly, that's not really much of a thing anymore, is it? So.
Well, it will be Cole Palmer in that centre attacking mid role. Over to the left mid position now. And we have that option of the FC Pro item Willian at left mid or the fantasy foot Luis Diaz. And Josh, I've heard from so many people how much they love that Willian item.
Yeah, very, very true. To be honest, I think that's be one I'd select straight away compared to Diaz. So we might as well keep the Fulham thing going, to be honest. And I think even though maybe Diaz has got some, obviously that better pace, which everyone sort of craves to have, I think Willian's the better card overall to use.
Willian I used in the first event as well, and he's a good card. He played for me left centre mid, but great on the ball and that. Diaz's card is more new, I think, and hasn't fully been upgraded, so it'll be Willian for now, definitely.
And Antonee, what's it been like having someone like Willian playing in front of you?
Yeah, it's amazing. I mean, obviously, one, for someone to, you know, have achieved what he has, and, you know, the age he is, to still come back and play with us, and you see in games, it's not like he's just, you know, cheating, hanging out. He is working so hard to help the team, track him back, defending, helps me out, listens to all the boys, gives instructions, and he's just got that bit of magic that can, you know, go and win the game.
And he is going to take that left mid position. And to finalise the team, we have our striker. We have got Raul Jimenez and also Armando Broja. You have one that you think can win this out for you?
Yeah, purely just off, you know, the pace. I'd go Broja. He's a bit bigger as well. It's 74, he's disrespected a bit as well. I think people think because he got injured, he's sly, he's a quick boy. Yeah, I'd go Broja up top, I think.
Well, that'll be it then. Broja will lead that front line for your ultimate dream team. So next up, we're going to be taking part in a 2v2 match. It is going to be me and Chris in the Fulham away kit, and then Antonee and Josh in the Fulham home kit. While we are playing, we're going to be asking some questions, getting to know you all a little bit better. So we'll go ahead and kick off, and then let's have some fun.
And we've got live Premier League action for you today.
Antonee, the EPL finals are coming up very, very soon. You've played in some big games in your life in the Premier League. Would you have any advice for our EPL finalists that are representing Fulham in terms of how to deal with nerves on that big stage?
My only advice would probably be that, you know, you're clearly both very good at the game. You've obviously done it, you know, played it a million times. So just don't change, you know, how you would approach as if you do it to any other game.
And Josh, this is going to be your second year
yeah.
at the Premier League finals. What do you kind of rate your chances to possibly go all the way and lift that trophy?
I definitely do. I feel like for myself, I practiced like really well coming up to the finals in January. I didn't get the result particularly that I wanted, didn't play great, but I know it sounds cliche, but try and sort of reflect on what you've done and try and do better in the finals.
Chance to get in behind with them.
What a ball.
Oh,
there you go.
Chance.
Teamwork.
Well played, mate.
Was that yourself that just put that in?
Yeah.
That's a calm and composed finish, that.
I'm focusing too much on the game rather than the questions. I'm not getting to know anyone here.
And Chris, what sort of preparation and training does it look like for yourself on a day-to-day basis?
You definitely have to train, stay with the cards and the meta of the game.
the meta being the most effective tactics available. That word gets thrown around all the time with gamers.
That's mental. I never knew what that meant.
What does it actually mean, Josh, when it's kind of coming in to each individual person? Chance comes through again.
A great ball, Anthony.
Chris, I'll take the blame here.
That's all right.
I'm not having a good one.
You're asking the questions.
Yeah, I'm asking the questions and not focusing enough. People at home who maybe want to get a little bit better, what does that actually mean for people, Josh?
The main thing that worked for me a lot was watching people better than me. I think that's the best sort of in any sport that you can try and do and then sort of implement it sort of over time.
Chance? Oh. Right, let's see what we can do from the corner. Whip that one in. Corner kick played in. Keep it there maybe? No. Chance?
Oh.
How much sort of time would someone like you take when it comes to analysing your own performance? You know, a game's been done, you look back and you see where you can improve. Is that something that just plays a massive part in football nowadays?
Yeah, it's a really big part. Obviously, we get the clips available to us to watch straight away and go home, try and dissect the match. Doesn't matter whether you win or lose, it's just the practice of, you know, trying to improve on them the next time.
Chance again. Oh. Tell you what, we are struggling here, Chris, to kind of find our way. Let's see if we can create some opportunities. Look through ball, maybe, on the overlap. Chance. Oh, the keeper's out.
Played.
I got nervy. All right, we're back in it. 2-1, just on the stroke of half-time as well. Well, Anthony, you said that you don't play too much of FC 24, but right now I've seen through balls from yourself, composed finishes.
I'm able to play the game, but I'm not Diogo Jota, put it that way.
Go on.
Ooh. Just about. Oh. Just about.
That's a pen, though.
That's a great, great challenge. Josh, you play, obviously, in the Premier League finals. For people at home, if you can give me kind of three quick tips, what do you think people need to take on board if they want to get better at FC 24?
So I think one thing for sure... Oh. I think his time finishing, it does help increase that sort of accuracy in your shooting, which is something I don't think many sort of casual players do. Adding in some skill moves, I think the best one is sort of step overs. The boost that you get from it is sort of unbelievable compared to any other sort of skill move that you do have.
Ball.
I'd say right stick switching for your defending as well, so you can sort of really anticipate rather than L1, which is just as the game sort of goes on.
Opportunity coming through. Defending's a little bit all over the place right now.
Go back on, post.
Oh, good save.
Told you about those back posts.
You did. You gave me the warning for them. Obviously, you've been representing your national team with the US as well and went to the World Cup. Was that just an experience of a lifetime for you and obviously wanting to build on that moving forward as well? Chance. Oh.
World Cup was amazing, obviously. I'm watching Tim Ream do the gritty, which is a bit mental. No, the World Cup, it was unbelievable having, you know, friends and family there and come to watch. You know, it's the biggest stage you can play at in football, so it was unbelievable.
Oh,
is he off? Is he on?
Yeah, it's off.
Oh, he's off. Can Anthony and Josh steal it in the last minute?
Surely not, eh?
Footwork down that right wing, cycles it back. Anthony on the edge of the box.
Oh,
the footwork.
Oh, I'm trying to step over through.
Away.
That was tough.
It was tough.
So we are going to make sure that we have a winner. We're going to do a penalty shootout. This year, penalties have changed, Josh, and you mentioned there about how they can change and you can go into either corner. What does that exactly mean?
So just basically means rather than just the left, right or middle, it gives you sort of two extra ways to score otherwise like a top corner, bottom corner. So it makes it actually harder to save, but makes penalty shootouts gone longer.
Did you just Panenka down the middle? That is beautiful. Right, one all in the penalty shootout. Oh! I'll save that for a save.
See if I can try and save it.
Surely.
Step up, Pereira.
Oh, lovely great finish. Pen. I went top.
Right, that gives me and Chris that lead.
Oh,
penalty. Right, Chris, don't let me down. Don't let me down. Oh,
that's not
great.
Not a good pen, is it?
Oh. I was going to say he wouldn't do it again, but he did. That just shows how much he doesn't respect me, really.
Oh. Pen.
See, that's where I dove down, but because you've aimed up,
this is where we can try and get a bit of an advantage.
And he steps up, top left, beautiful penalty.
Is there anything you see in people taking pens where you think you know where they're going?
I just go off gut feeling a lot of the time.
It's in, no messing. This could go a long way.
Safe to win.
All right, don't let me down, Chris. The last one wasn't good enough. Can't be three in a row. Yeah, good penalty.
Good penalty.
I've gone the same way as you twice, but I've just gone either too high or too low.
Oh, you've
beautiful
gone.
Penalty. Right. Beautiful indeed. We're now into sudden death. Reem steps up. Straight down the middle. Chris, you have to score this, all right?
Oh, no. I feel the pressure.
Go on, Anthony. Save to win.
No Panenka again.
I've aimed that way as well. Don't know what more I can do there.
Anthony steps up for his penalty. He goes straight down the middle. We are in sudden death, so I have to score this.
No pressure, Matt.
No pressure at all.
Nice.
That's a save. Well, there we have it. We had to go all the way to penalties.
No legging it. That's amazing.
So there we have it. It is going to be me and Chris that pick up that loss. Unfortunately, Antonee and Josh do get that victory. Make sure you tune in to the ePremier League finals this weekend to go ahead and support your team.